Welcome to QGIS 101. My name is Andreas de Jong, and in today's video, I want to show you how to calculate the daily precipitation over your basin using the CHIRPS dataset. I hope you enjoy it. A catchment is a total area upstream of a point of interest, for example, a dam, which contributes to the surface runoff at that location. Surface runoff is controlled to a large extent by the amount and distribution of precipitation over the catchment. Today we're going to be looking at the CHIRPS dataset to determine precipitation over a catchment. CHIRPS stands for Climate Hazards Group Infrared Precipitation with Station Data. What this means is that it is a satellite-based precipitation product that has been calibrated to some extent using actual data from ground stations. You can read more about CHIRPS at this website. I'll leave a link in the description below. CHIRPS extends 50 degrees north and south of the equator, which means it's quasi-global. It has a spatial resolution of 0.05 degrees, that's about 5,500 meters at the equator. And we can get a time series starting on the 1st of January 1981. That means that we have 40 years of continuous data. The native time step is the pentad, which is the amount of precipitation which falls over a 5-day period. But we can also access daily estimates as well as monthly and annual summaries. Today we're going to be looking at the Salma Dam catchment in Afghanistan, which was completed in 2016. It is located on the Harut River in the west of the country. So what we'll do is we'll take the CHIRPS precipitation dataset and extract only the precipitation which fell over our catchment and then convert that into a daily time series from 1981 to 2020, so over a 40-year period. We can then look at this time series and see if there's any trends in the data. The easiest way to get hold of CHIRPS data is through the Google Earth engine. Today we're going to be using the Climate Engine app, which is a cloud-based app. What this means is that all calculations are done in the cloud and all you need is a good internet connection and Google Chrome to use this app. Today we're going to be using QGIS 3.16 Hanover, and as I said, please have Google Chrome installed on your computer so you can access the Earth Engine and the Climate Engine. Finally, we'll look at our data in Excel. Okay, let's get started. The first thing we need to do is to export the catchment to a shapefile in WGS84 coordinate system. Here's the catchment polygon which we made in the previous videos. I'm just going to switch off the digital elevation model and the hillshade. I can see this location of the Salma Dam here, and the black outline is our catchment. So this polygon is projected in 41 north, and what we'd like to do is just to put it into geographic. So I'm going to export it, save features as, and it is already a shapefile, which is good. The file name will be this one here, Salma Catchment 30 meters Google Earth Engine, and the CRS will be WGS84. Say okay. And I'm going to override the file because I had already made it previously. So here in pink is our new shapefile in WGS84. The next step is to check the vector geometry of our catchment shapefile. The way we do that is we go to Vector, Geometry Tools, Check Validity. And it has already selected the correct layer. And we'll just run it. It's going to put a whole bunch of outputs into temporary files. Okay. Now there's an error output point. We'll put that on top. And let's just switch off some of these. Now valid output, I can't see anything, but invalid output, which is this brown color, our whole catchment is invalid. Now we need to see where our problem is. And it's right here. There's a little dot here. And what you can see is that there's actually a hole in our polygon, which is not a good thing. So what we'll do is I'm going to go to switch on the catchment shapefile, which is pink. Maybe we'll just change that to another color. What we need to do is edit this so that we don't have a hole anymore. So either we delete all of the points inside, or maybe we can just open up this little area here. So what we'll do is go to the pen to start editing, and the vertex tool, current layer, click on this vertex, and you can see it's already ready to move. Click on that one, maybe move it here, and our editing is done. Before we end this, I'm just going to open the attribute table, and let's call it Salma under the label. Stop editing, save edits, close. And just to be sure, let's run the check again. So we're going to remove these temporary layers and go to Vector, Geometry Tools, Check Validity, and this time I've selected the correct layer, and press Run and close. Now, if you look here, the valid output should be brown. It's still not brown. We're still invalid, and actually there's a little dot up here now, which is interesting because it didn't see it the first time around. And we have a similar problem. So let's switch on the editing mode, vertex tool, current layer. As we go over it, we can see the vertexes. We just click on it and okay, I've selected the top one and maybe like so. We'll stop editing now, save, and because for some reason this hasn't worked the first time, I'm going to be ultra sure and check it again. Go to Vector, Geometry Tools, Check Validity. It looks like we have a valid output, because invalid output is not shown, only valid output. So that's great. We can delete our temporary layers and we now have a valid polygon shapefile of the Salma Dam catchment. The next step is to import the catchment shapefile to Google Earth Engine. So what I've done is I've put all the files from our Salma catchment shapefile into this folder here, and I've zipped the folder into a zip file. If you haven't done so already, go to earthengine.google.com and sign yourself up for an account. Once you've done that, it should take a couple of hours. You can go to Code Editor, and on the left side, if you click on Assets and New, where it says Table Upload, select Shapefiles. Press the red button for Select, and I have on my desktop here the zip file. We open it, and it's called the Salma catchment, but I'm going to add a couple more words for it. AF Afghanistan, Haruk Murgab River Basin, Salma catchment, and upload. So here on the right on the tasks, you can see that it is starting to ingest the asset. It has completed, and if we refresh here, we should see it. There we go. This is our new asset, and you can see a picture of it here, and we can add a description here if you want to. First of all, I'm going to move it to my Afghanistan folder, and then I'm going to share it and anybody, and I'll just copy it, press done. The next step is to extract the CHIRPS data using Climate Engine. Go back to Google Chrome, open the Climate Engine website. You'll see a little introductory tour here. You just close that, and we don't want to make a map today, we're going to make a graph. So click on Make Graph, and where it says region, we're going to select custom polygon from Table Asset. Click on it. And here, if you have trouble understanding my video, you can do a tutorial on how to create a Google Table Asset. All we need to do now is to paste our asset in, press return, and be a little bit patient. There we go, it has loaded, and you can see the Salma Dam catchment that's here out there. It's looking good. Pick a region. We're going to pick Salma. Remember, we added that to the shapefile earlier. Now, the variable that we want, or the data set that we want rather, is chirps. And what we'll do today is get the daily precipitation in millimeters. That's great. The resolution is 4,800 meters. That's okay. We'd like to have the mean statistic over our catchment. That's great. And for the time period, let's go and download the entire period of record data set, which goes back to 1981 until the end of April. Get time series. Now, it takes a little bit of time, so be patient. Now, just remember that the processing is happening on the Google computers in different parts of the world, and we're just waiting for them to complete their calculations. Okay, so that's just under 3 minutes. It has completed the calculations, and you can see here precipitations of the Salma catchment since 1981. Let's download the data. I'm going to download it straight away as an XLS. The next step is to process the data in Excel. If we open the file we've just downloaded, it's going to give us a warning. But don't worry about it, we'll just open it. And you'll see we have just two columns of data. One is the date, and one is the data in millimeters per day over the catchment from 1981 all the way until current, which is the end of April 2021. So we've got quite a bit of data here. Let's have a look at it using the template. So I've got a chirps template here. I make a copy of it, paste, and I'm going to call it Salma Dam catchment, and drop it into Excel. Rename the catchment name to Salma Dam. And what we need to do now is collect the data, shift, control, arrow down, control C, go to data, under date time, paste special 123, and just want to copy these numbers down as well. So this is now our data table. I can see all the data going down to the current date. The next sheet is a time series. I'm going to have to get rid of the filter, or actually what we need to do is to refresh it. Okay, so this is a pivot table and a pivot chart, so we can see all the precipitation over the time series. Here is the precipitation of the years. Obviously 2021 hasn't finished yet, so it's a bit low. Here we can see the seasonal variations. This is an interesting one. The blue line is the precipitation in January, February, March, and you can see that in the year 2021 it's the lowest precipitation since 1985, so it's a pretty bad year as far as precipitation goes. And on the last one here, we see the average. And we have to be careful now that we only use completed years, so up to 2020. I can see here the average precipitation for each month. Basically, May is the last month we expect some precipitation before October. Okay, I hope you've enjoyed this little video, and that you try some of the techniques yourself to find out how much precipitation you've received in different catchments. And see you on the next one, where we'll look at evapotranspiration rates over the Salma catchment.